Going to start. Fine. Admit. Now you can see or not on the screen. This you can see or not?
Yes, sir.
Sir, see. Yes, sir.
A computer is a general purpose written over here. You can see that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I am today lecture. I have to discuss about what is computer. Actually, what is computer? What is generation of computer? How it has been emerged from? How many generations of computers are there? Different type of memories. So this topic I have to cover for today. So it is the definition of computer. Actually, a computer is a general purpose electronic device that is performing arithmetic or logical operation automatically. That means computer is a electronic device by which we can perform certain operations, whether it is arithmetic calculation or logical operation, whatever it is, the computer is able to perform that. So computer block diagram is over here, architecture of computer, you can call that. So computer consists of what things that is being mentioned over here. See, a general purpose of, you can see that mainly computer consists of three part. That is input device, that means whatever input we are providing to the computer. Central processing unit, CPU. CPU consists of many things we will discuss later on. Actually, it is the brain of the computer, means most of the things are working from here on. And output device. CPU divided into two parts. That means CPU basically divided into two parts. That is ALU and CU. That means control unit and arithmetic logical unit. So this you can see the diagram, block diagram of computer. That means it consists of storage. What are storage unit over here? Storage unit are two type of storage are there. One is primary storage, second one is secondary storage. So primary storage, what is primary storage? Actually, the computer or CPUs can access the primary storage directly. That means CPU, central processing unit, can access the primary storage directly. And in secondary storage, it is vast memory, actually much memory there in secondary storage. Like you, if you have seen, you know hard disk. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
You all know hard disk?
Yes, sir.
So hard disk is a secondary storage. That means whatever computer want to read from that disk storage, that have to brought first into primary storage, into main memory. Okay, primary storage is also known as main memory. So whatever the computer want to perform the action on storage, first of all, that thing must come in the primary storage, that means in main memory. And input unit, like keyboard, mouse, all these things are input unit. Whatever input we can provide through keyboard or anything, that is input unit. And output unit, where you are getting your result, like printer, monitor, all these things are output unit. So a CPU consists of two things, that is control unit and arithmetical and logical unit. We will discuss about this later on. Okay, the full form of CPU is central processing unit. And ALU full form is arithmetic logic unit. So here it is given what is CPU, CPU known as central processing unit and like that. It is brain or it is written here heart, heat, it is not heat, actually it is heart. So you can see this or not, whatever I am showing on the screen. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You can read this, central processing unit is written over here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So you can see that CPU is a electronic hardware device which can perform different operations, like we have already discussed which type of operation is performing, ALU and logical. So control unit, what is control unit? So control unit control each and everything that is performed on the computer system, whether it is inside whatever operation or activity performed on computer system that is being controlled by the control unit. So it receives information directly from main memory of the computer. So what it does, control unit convert that information or instruction to control signal. That means that instructions are, whatever instruction it is getting from main memory, that instruction is being transferred into control signals in the form of signals. So these signals are sent to central processing for further processing. That means for further processing, what is happening? First of all, from main memory, the instructions are coming to the control unit. Then control unit is converting that to the in the form of control signals. And that control signal is going into central processing unit for processing purpose. So what is arithmetic logical unit? That means ALU can see, you already know that, everyone know that, what is binary number? Hello?
Yes, sir.
You know what is binary number? That is in form of zeros and ones. So you must know that computer don't know anything except zero and one. That means it can, it is performing all the operation just in zero and one form. That means in binary number form. Binary means two. So zero and one. So computer only understands all things in form of zero and one. So arithmetic logic unit can perform these operations on integer binary numbers. So bitwise logical operator, you will read it later on. So storage unit, that means what is a storage unit? Wherever we save the information, wherever information is being saved, that is known as, wherever the information is being saved, that is known as storage or storage device. That means you can see that suppose we are downloading we are storing the film, movie. So where it is being stored? Hello?
In the memory.
In the hard disk or storage memory. Yeah, storage device is known as hard disk. So there all the information is being stored. So we can say that computer, there is a storage for the computer, and that storage being divided into two storage part. One is main memory and primary memory we can say, and second one is secondary memory. Okay, so what is secondary memory? See, if you will see the example of secondary memory, if you want to see the example of secondary memory, you can say hard disk, floppy disk. Floppy, you know, na?
Hello? Yes, sir.
So floppy disk, where floppy is being floppy disk is an example of secondary memory. Like CD is also an example of secondary memory. So what is primary memory? Inside primary memory, if you will see, यू विल सी कैश मेमोरी, ठीक है, कैश मेमोरी, मेन मेमोरी, ऑल दीज थिंग आर रैम, रोम, रैंडम एक्सेस मेमोरी, रीड ओनली मेमोरी, ऑल दीज थिंग कम अंडर द प्राइमरी मेमोरी या मेन मेमोरी. सो दीज आर कंपोनेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम्स आर बीइंग शोन ओवर हियर. So all these things you can see, this is monitor. If someone are not aware, very aware regarding this, so this is known as TV like structure, it is monitor. It is printer, whatever printout, everyone knows nowadays what is printer, what is keyboard and what is mouse. So you can read here what is main memory. That means random access memory is main memory of computer system, which is known as RAM. What we call main memory? RAM. That means random access memory. So what RAM, inside RAM, what is being stored? Operating system, software, application software and other information. See, you know what is operating system? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Do you know what is operating system?
Yes, sir.
So what is operating system? Can anyone can say? Hello?
The system which operates, sir.
Operate. Very good. And any other answer?
Such as Windows, Microsoft.
Very good. Any other answer?
Operating system performs all the basic tasks like file management, performs memory management, process management, handling input and output, and controlling peripheral devices such as disk drives and printers.
Anything else? See,
it is also an interface between computer user and computer hardware.
That I want to say. See, you can see that if we want to interact with the computer, so how to interact? We cannot directly interact with the computer. Okay. So whatever we will say, computer will not able to understand. And whatever computer will give the feedback, we will not be able to understand. So it is like it is acting like a interface between human being and computer. ठीक है? Operating system is like an interface between human being and the machine or computer, whatever you call. So that is work of software. So what is application software over here? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So what is application software? Hello, anyone can say? So operating system, you can see you already given the answer, like Windows operating system, 2098 XP, these are Unix operating system, Linux operating system. These are the examples of operating systems.
Yes.
So what is the application software?
Sir, such as applications of Google, we can say email.
Whatever you want to say. See, I'm saying that application software, like for typing, we are using Notepad. We are using Notepad. So it is application software, like clock we are using. Whatever the application means, programming it done for making the application, for making the software like clock, calendar, whatever it is. So these all are application software. So we can say that RAM is, what is our main memory? RAM is our main memory. So RAM is the fastest memory to read the data and write the data. So you can see about the secondary memory. See, not only RAM, primary memory consists of RAM, ROM, read-only memory, cache memory, all these are primary memory. Now, what is secondary memory? secondary memory are cheap. Hard disk, floppy disk, all these are secondary memory. Okay. So you can read or read down this. I will provide the notes on Google Classroom. Fine. Hello.
Yes, sir. Okay, yes, sir.
So I will provide all these notes on Google Classroom. You will so you can read out from there. So input device, like example, I have given here, scanner, joystick, mouse, keyboard. These all are input device. In the similar way. See, what input device does? Accept data instruction from user. That means whatever we are typing or we are doing anything, that is accepted from the input device. Then what input device does? That data is being converted into the form of instruction. That means whatever data we are providing in English, Urdu, Hindi, Bengali, whatever language we are providing the data, that machine could not understand. So for understanding the machine, we use machine readable form. That is known as instructions. Take it. That means that is converted into the instruction so that machine can further processes or read it. Okay. So example, you already know about input device, keyboard, mouse, scanner, all these things are joystick, all these things are input device. So what is output device? Input device, it is written. See, output device so like printer, monitor, all these things are output device. So what is cache memory? I was talking about the primary memory consists of RAM, ROM, cache. So what is cache memory? So cache is a hardware or software component of computer memory. That means inside computer memory, it is hardware part or software parts. The cache memory can store data for future requests. Suppose what is stored in the cache memory? Suppose we are processing for any data most of the time. So that data is being stored in the cache memory so we can process it in a quick manner. If you want to access that any data fastly, so data, where data is being kept? Data is being kept in hard disk. In secondary memory, where data is being kept? Hello? Hello?
Hard disk.
In
hard disk. Hard disk.
That is secondary memory. Okay? Hard disk.
Yes, sir.
So now when you have to, computer had to process it and want to read something from there. So what computer, what processing is, CPU is doing? Taking that data into main memory or taking that data into primary memory. Fine. So what is cache memory? Cache memory, whatever data we are frequently reading or writing, whatever we are performing on that. So that data is being stored and in the cache memory. So we can, if we want to retrieve that data again and again, we can retrieve directly from the cache memory. That I have not to be bring from the secondary memory hard disk. So that data will be stored in cache memory. Are you getting what I'm saying or not about cache memory?
Yes, sir.
What you got? Now explain me.
Cache memory is a memory in which future used, in which memory is stored for future use or anything. No. It is also a hardware component.
What I said, listen, once more. I'm saying that everything is stored in the secondary memory. Fine? Hard disk. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Inside computer, yes, where it is being stored? In hard disk.
Yes, sir.
That is secondary memory. When computer want to perform any operation, it cannot directly access hard disk. Okay? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
What you
yes,
got?
Yes, sir.
A CPU cannot directly access the hard disk. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Oh, if you want to access that data, first of all, that data has to be brought from hard disk to the primary memory. Okay. So,
yes, sir.
So bringing again and again, it is very tedious task. That means much time it will take. So that particular thing are stored in the cache memory. So we have not to bring that data again and again from the hard disk. Do you got my answer? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
You got cache memory? And everything you can read out over here, it is written. Okay, I will provide these notes. See, this is CPU. This is main memory. So what we have to do, if we want something to bring operation done in the CPU, we have to require for the main memory. And main memory, that data will have to be fetched from there to the fetched to the primary memory from the secondary memory. So what is here? CPU can directly access the cache memory. Suppose that data is in main memory also. So block transfer it will take from main memory to cache memory. That is slow. And if CPU want to access, most of the time it is performing certain action on certain data. If that data is being stored in the cache memory, then it can even faster access that data, CPU. Okay. So it is basically different between, before I talked about secondary memory and main memory. Now I'm talking about that. If certain data is stored in the RAM, suppose. So CPU want to read that. Okay? From main memory. So that has to perform the block transfer. And block transfer always take the more time than the byte transfer. So this is, I think, so sufficient for you. For the memory, RAM, ROM, everything is written over here. You can read it out. It is a theoretical thing. See, software are two types that is mentioned here. One is system software. Second one is the application software. What is system software? Operating system, system development software, utility programs like we will. What is utility programs? Okay. And second one is application software. That means these programs are developed by the users. Like MS Word, Lotus, Microsoft, Excel, Word, Excel, all these are application software. I already mentioned you. So all the definition is given over here. You can read down operating system and everything. Okay, I think so now. Micro RAM, RAM, ROM. See RAM, ROM, EPROM, all these definitions are given here. So I think so today lecture is enough or you want to read more? Hello. Hello, actually time is out for, in this Zoom. Hello.
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
today more you want to study, yes, or shall we stop over here and study next day?
Enough.
So next we have to read, actually it is also theoretical part, that is generations of computer. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And anything, see myself, Satan Bias. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Actually, today I wanted to take the introduction class. So I have taken this class. And myself, Satan Bias, if you are having any doubt regarding this, you can ask me. You can contact me. My mobile number I am giving to you, 960. Hello.
Yes, sir.
You can note down my mobile number, 960-908-1282.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, if you are having regarding the means, I will okay, teach sir. You C language also. Hello. Hmm?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I will teach you C also. That means in this semester, at least C will come in your next semester. But basic C language I will teach you in this semester itself. First of all, okay, this sir. I will teach means generation of computer. Okay, and after see how I will go course by. Actually, today I have just given you the introduction brief about computer. After that, I will teach you generation of computers. And after that, we have to convert number from binary, decimal to binary to decimal. All these things we have to do. After that, I will start taking basic of C language, programming
okay,
language.
Okay.
Okay. So okay, after two lectures, we will begin from there.
Thank you, sir.
If you are having any problem, you can contact me. Fine. Bye.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Good afternoon and thank you, sir.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, that's all.